The Autumn Woodland Tea Party, written and illustrated by Elle, Steward. Published by Lolly Publishing. Fox woke up bright-eyed and bushy-tailed. He brushed his whiskers, rushed past the stream, and ran off to Badger's home, skidding to a halt at his door. Knock, 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 knock. Badger appeared wrapped in his warm blanket. Hello? Oh, Fox, good day, he said. Do you know what would make today even better, bubbled Fox? A party! We can gather everyone together and have an autumn tea party in the glen. What a grand idea, said Badger. And we can do it before everyone hibernates for the winter. It's perfect. So it was settled. An autumn tea party was to be had. Fox and Badger set to work right away preparing it. Badger's first order of business was to remove his fuzzy blanket and ensconce himself in a big, cozy scarf. Then he set off to visit everyone in the woods and invite them to the autumn tea party. Fox skipped home, excited to be having a party. It was his absolute favorite thing. He even took an extra turn around the bend to collect wild blackberries for his special blackberry muffins. Badger hurried through the woods, noticing the brightly colored leaves carpeting the ground, and knew that winter was on its way. He soon came to a brambly thicket near the edge of the trees. I do hope she hasn't gone into hibernation just yet, he said, looking into the brush. Turning over a rather large leaf, he discovered the little hedgehog already curled up, fast asleep. Good night, hedgehog, whispered Badger, carefully tucking the leaf back around her and tiptoeing away. Fox was busy in his burrow, baking blackberry muffins and making a right mess of things with the flour. Badger hurried on to invite another friend. He came to a dense area with acorns, chestnuts, and walnuts scattered about, and heard a frantic scurrying noise coming from under the leaves. What about this hiding spot? An anxious voice murmured. Oh, but what if I forget them there? Better put them over there. I might forget them there, too. Oh, dear. There you are, Squirrel, said Badger, smiling. I've come to invite you to our autumn tea party. Oh, Squirrel exclaimed, popping up from under the leaves and bouncing over to Badger. So kind, very considerate, but I'm afraid I'm very busy and stressed about hiding my supply of nuts before winter arrives. That's all right, Badger said. If you change your mind, you're welcome to join us. Your friends are always here for you. Squirrel took a deep breath and smiled. Thank you, dear friend. I'll be sure to remember that and not forget it. Like where I hide my nuts. And with that, Squirrel scurried into the leaves once more. Badger laughed and went on his way. Back in his burrow, Fox was just taking the last of his muffins out of the oven and feeling very proud of himself, for they smelled marvelous. Badger came to a clearing with a large tree stump in the middle and found Bear snoozing beside it. He tapped Bear gently. Hello, said Badger. Bear yawned, her eyes fluttering open. Hello, Badger. I'm glad you aren't hibernating yet, Badger said. I'd love for you to help me gather some heather and join us for a tea party.
Sounds lovely, said Bear, yawning and stretching.
The two ambled along together, picking purple tufts of heather as they went. Badger and Bear steeped the heather in Badger's favorite tea set, while Fox gathered up an armful of his freshly baked muffins. At last, with the muffins made and the tea prepared, everyone met in the glen for their autumn woodland tea party. The breeze was crisp and the leaves fell around them. Badger told stories while they sipped their tea. Fox invented fun games for them to play. And Bear was her usual sweet, quiet self. She did yawn quite a bit. As different as they all were, the little group of friends appreciated and cherished each other. Their cozy autumn tea party was the perfect way to spend the afternoon together. Once all the crumbs had been eaten, the last drop of tea drunk, Fox and Badger tucked Bear into her home for the winter. Fox bounced back over the stream to snuggle up in his den, and Badger returned to his burrow to wrap himself in his fuzzy blanket. They all slept soundly with happy memories and sweet dreams to warm them in the chilly night air. The end.